Welcome back. Well, the news of Chris Jones's sudden departure from the Riders still shocking fans across the province. And today, more reaction pouring in, along with some details about how Jones ended up making the jump to the NFL's Cleveland Browns. But where do the Riders go from here? Welcome back. Well, the Saskatchewan Roughriders making a major football operations announcement today, naming Jeremy O'Day as the franchise's 15th general manager. This after former GM Chris Jones left the team to join the NFL's Cleveland Browns. Welcome back. Well, for the past few seasons, the Regina Pats have been no strangers to winning streaks. But this year, they're on the other side of things as they lost back-to-back games against Saskatoon on the weekend to bring their losing streak to 10 games. On Friday night, Regina was outshot 34-17 and lost 6-2 to the Blades. And while they played better on Saturday at home as they managed to outshoot Saskatoon 33-32, the Queen City Club still lost 4-2. Now, as the Pats aren't back in action until Friday against Brandon, they'll take this week to work on the little things and not let the losing streak eat at them. Just a few days into his new job, but the work has already begun for newly appointed Riders general manager Jeremy O'Day. First up is finding a head coach, but according to some reports, the Winnipeg Blue Bombers have denied the Riders a chance to interview Paul Lapolis for the job, while the Ottawa Redblacks have reportedly denied an interview with their offensive coordinator, Jamie Elizondo, as well. Well, the quest to represent Saskatchewan at the Scotties Tournament of Hearts is underway this week in Humboldt, as 9 teams from across the province vie for that green jacket and a spot in the national tournament in Nova Scotia next month. In the opening draw this afternoon, it was Regina's Amber Holland and her rink taken on Sherry Just from Saskatoon. How close were you to signing a new contract in Saskatchewan? It was well documented. We've heard the Riders' side of the story. What's your side of the story when it comes to how the negotiations went?
Thanks, guys. With Rams quarterback Noah Pickton here on the sidelines. And Noah, so far so good for you guys. 3 touchdown drives. What's working?
I talked to John Paddock before the game. He admitted that Sanford needed to pick up his game a little bit. Just 3 goals and 1 assist in these first 9 games.
It is time for our weekly Pat Chat with Voice of the Pats, Phil the Thrill Andrews. Phil, what a start for this Regina Pats team so far. Well, it's a marquee matchup tonight here at the Brandt Center as the Eastern Conference leading Regina Pats will host one of the top teams in the Western Conference in the Everett Silvertips.
Well, the Mackenzie Tour PGA Tour Canada is back just south of Saskatoon for the 9th annual Sega Dakota Dunes Open.
Well, there is a lot on the line tonight here at the Brandt Center as the Regina Pats are set to host the Saskatoon Blades. Taylor Shire alongside Riders receiver Rob Begg, and Rob, CFL week is just over a month away and excitement's already building.
Following tonight's game, the Pats will be in Moose Jaw tomorrow night for a date with the Warriors. They'll return here to the Brandt Center next Friday, 1 week from today, when they host the Swift Current Broncos.
And here in his home of Imperial, Saskatchewan, the 19-year-old Ingram has been the talk of the town from old to young.
We're going to see a lot of speed out there tonight. Both teams, Moose Jaw has a quick team up front and so is Regina, but it's really going to come down to goaltending.
It's a good one.
Connor Ingram is finally getting a chance to enjoy some R&R.
It's been hockey for 6 months, and I'm a big believer in you got to have a life away from the game. You can't let hockey define you as much as people want to talk about. That's all we are. It's when you walk down the street, you're just a hockey player now. You're not a person anymore.
It's been a hectic last few weeks for the 19-year-old. After playing for Team Canada at the World Juniors, Ingram's WHL team, the Kamloops Blazers, gave him a few days away from the rink, allowing him to come back to his hometown of Imperial.
It's good to get time away, especially if it's out here where you can just kind of hide almost and duck your head and go get the mail and do whatever you want without people noticing you, so it's exciting.
But that doesn't mean he hasn't been noticed from many in his hometown and surrounding area that have supported him.
Oh, nice!
We were Watchers yesterday and walking around the grocery store, even you gotta keep your head down a little bit, but it's been fun. Whether it's a little lady telling me that they watched hockey for the first time or whatever it is, it's pretty cool. And I wouldn't change it for the world. It's a little different, but it's good being out here where people know my name and just recognize me for being the kid from the Ingram house. So it's good to get away.
The time at home has also given him a chance to reflect on that silver medal finish.
Us having a silver medal is still pretty cool. It's not gold, but still something nobody can take away from you, and I'll have for the rest of my life if I can manage not to lose it.
And it's given him a chance to reflect to where it all began, growing up with his parents, Joni and Brent, and 3 other brothers in Imperial.
It's pretty cool to go from mini sticks on this floor to national TV. They've always been there with me, and they've helped me out along the way. I always tell people that's why I'm so tough. So a silver medal, a gold medal, it's an experience, and it's something nobody can take away from you. It's something to tell my kids about one day, hopefully.
Taylor Shire, Global Sports.
Thanks for coming in. Don't leave me hanging. Please.
Oh, yeah, give you a potato. It's harvest season. Don't do that. That's not manly. Just the potato.
Really?
Yeah, you can't. Who does that? You can't.
Burger and fries.
A truck driver would never go.
This is true.
Yeah, just give
I've
me.
I learned so much this morning.
Give me a solid. Boom.
They lifted the 1,500 kilogram vehicle by hand. Amazingly, the woman suffered only minor injuries. Have a look at that.
That's so hard to watch, but thankfully she's okay.
Yikes.
Wow.
It would have been a little easier if that car was a pickup truck.